We will not stand for this type of activity. We will not stand for disgrace of the badge. In the interest of trust and transparency, I want to let the community know that we do have the capacity to investigate our own.
That is Interim Baltimore City Police Commissioner Gary Tuggle at a news conference this afternoon announcing the arrest of police officer Spencer Moore. He was a 14-year veteran. He was arrested in Baltimore County last night for drug trafficking. He had been suspended C4 for several months on an unrelated issue from the Baltimore City Police Department. The drugs trafficked prescription drugs, and this was a joint investigation between Baltimore City, Baltimore County Police, and the DEA.
You know, Robert, this, unfortunately, first of all, I appreciate the Baltimore City Police Department, as Commissioner Tuggle said, being transparent and coming out talking about this. But this fulfills a narrative that tragically is left by the Gun Trace Task Force unit of police officers actively engaged in putting drugs back on the street, whether they be illegal or legal. Because if you remember, part of the information that came out in that federal investigation of the GTTF had to do with prescription drugs that were taken off of people after the riots of 2015, when 31 pharmacies were raided during the riots. And those officers took those legal prescription drugs and then flooded them back out into the streets.
And another thing announced was regarding another incident. We'll recall back on July 6th, it was caught in dash cam video by the Baltimore City Fire Department. A police officer responding to a call, or the officers witnessed this, of a man dumping a gun on St. Paul Street.
It was two fire people that called.
They called it in to city police. A female police officer said, "That's not my district," and did not respond. Well, Interim Commissioner Tuggle announced today that that officer has been separated from the agency, i.e. fired.
I was about to say, well, let's break it down, no longer there. But really, the question needs to be asked, how pervasive is that? As you remember, Robert, Commissioner Tuggle said that that was an anomaly that did not represent the men and women of the Baltimore City Police Department. We all want to believe that. But the way that officer kind of responded, matter-of-factly, but it's not my district, you have to wonder whether there's a cultural problem inside the police department that they are working to the job, so to speak.
And does this lead to the increased skepticism by the city council? We saw the vote last week.
$21 million
held up. It's money that's already been spent.
That's what the mayor said today.
That's what the mayor said today.
Well, I think it does. It leads to skepticism, Robert, from the populace that, yes, we appreciate the police responding to 911 calls and doing that, but are they doing more than that? Are they doing in a city as violent as Baltimore more that would help drive crime down? That's what the city council is asking. I think that's what taxpayers deserve to know, Robert.
All right. C4 back 9 to 1 tomorrow on WBAL News Radio 1090.